Photographing lavenders is not as difficult as one might think. Hello everybody, my name is Mads Peter Iversen. I'm a Danish fine art landscape photographer. I started out this YouTube channel to make videos about different landscape locations and all the practical matters that comes with landscape photography at these locations. Having this information yourself, of course, doesn't mean that you can't go and take original content yourself and explore the area. It's just very nice to have a starting point for where the classic shots from different landscape locations have been shot. In this video we will go to Provence in France and I will tell you a bit about where to photograph lavenders. Lavender season in France is during summer from around mid-June to the end of July, which depends on heat, rainfall and the height of the field above the sea. But if you come around start July, you won't be disappointed. We were there in mid-June, which for the most part worked out really well. There's a few places to check out the lavender fields, which are mainly found in the region of Provence, around the town of Sault, Gortz and Valensol. After having explored all three places, Valensol was without shadow of a doubt the best location with the most clean fields and opportunity for isolating single objects in the fields. They even have signs along the road D8 warning about tourists and photographers. The classic shot with the lavender fields leading up to the isolated tree you will find at a place called Lavenders of Provence, and excuse my French. This location is located along D8 west of Valensol. But sure do go explore the entire area around Valensol. There's a lot of opportunities for beautiful pictures. There's lots of small ruined stone houses and other points of interest in the many, many fields. Good morning from the lavender fields of Provence. We are now just a bit outside of Valensol. I have found a beautiful little composition here with an old ruined house and the lavender fields in front of it. We have the leading lines leading up to a strong central composition. It is fairly simple. I will shoot a few different compositions with a wide angle and a bit more zoomed in. I'm shooting with a fairly small aperture as to get as much in focus as possible. Yesterday I focused on the backlit lavenders and it's the same this morning. So we are having the sun coming up over here somewhere and that should give a nice glow to the lavenders. A location which is considered a must-see in the region is the Abbey Notre Dame de Signon, located a bit north of the town of Gortz. When we were there, the lavenders either hadn't started blooming in the courtyard or they were in very sad conditions. If you know anything about this, please do share it down below in the comment. We were there a bit early in the season, so the flowers might not have started blooming yet. Considered the conditions of the lavenders, I actually found a better perspective from a bit further away from the abbey along the road leading into the abbey. The lavender fields in themselves are so very beautiful that you can actually shoot them in all lighting conditions and get good pictures. If you, however, want to go one step further and make amazing pictures, the golden hour is the time to do it. Not so much because of the colors, but because of how the light hits the fields and only illuminates the top of the lavenders, making the small flowers glow. What surprised me the most was it doesn't really matter if the lavenders are backlit, frontlit, sidelit, as long as you hit that magic time with the low-hanging sun. Of course, the effect will be different depending on the direction of the sun, but I'd say the effects are equally beautiful. Depending on the field you're shooting in, you have to be aware that when the sun dips too low, big shadows will occur in the fields if there's many hills. That's why it's important to start photographing already an hour before sunset, and on the other end you might have to wait a few minutes after sunrise to even get an effect on the fields from the sun. I definitely prefer the longer end of the focal length. Zooming in helps compressing the rows, which squeezes the flowers closer together, which then again enhances the effect of the colors and the rows. And then you have to be aware of bees. There are a lot of bees because obviously it's a flower field. And if you are allergic, it might be walking into a death trap. When you're driving around in Provence, there's some absolutely beautiful towns to visit along the road. Most of them are fairly old, yet very clean and has that southern European feel to them. Most have some beautiful viewpoints, which are obvious for blue hour cityscape photography. Of course, in daylight, they are also beautiful, but remember your polarizer to darken the sky and remove the haze. I've just been interviewed by Paul from Photography TV, so be sure to check out that interview in the link just up here. I think it will be up here. Photography TV is a fairly new photography channel with already some superb quality from landscape photographers such as Thomas Heaton and Nick Page. Thanks so much for watching. I hope you found this episode from Provence in France enlightening, or at least informative. And I would highly appreciate a like, and if you want to follow on even more, you can subscribe to the channel. If you have anything to say, any questions or whatever, you can also ask down below in the comment section. I really appreciate all the comments and I've tried to get back to all of you. This is the first video on my series from Europe, and this is not really going to be a series per se with episodes. This is just going to be like individual videos. And yeah, that's about it.